In today's Do Something With Your Marketing, I want you to investigate the details of your mailing list or your LinkedIn connections. Either way, we want to get a better understanding of who our audience is. Now, there are a number of ways to do this, but probably the way that I like best, because it doesn't cost any money to do it, is to upload a copy of a mailing list to a service like Clearbit. Now, there are many data append services such as data.com, NetProspects, and stuff like that. Clearbit, however, is one of the few. Full disclosure, they have not paid me. They have not even given me anything. They just have a really good service. So just get that out of the way. What they have is an interesting way you can upload a mailing list, a list of email addresses to Clearbit, and then it will give you an analysis of who is on your mailing list, and then you can buy the data. That's where they make their money, for like 10 cents a name. And so if you have a large mailing list, you realize just how stunningly expensive that is. But for getting the broad information about your mailing list, there is no better way to do that. Now, who is this good for? If you're a marketer, certainly you want to know who's on your mailing list. If you are a salesperson, you definitely want to know what kinds of companies and things you are going to be looking at or you have in your database. And if you are an influencer, you need this service. And again, this part of it, the part we're going to show today, is completely free of financial cost, and it will help you understand your list better as an influencer so that you can better present yourself to companies and understand and what value it is that you provide. So let's look at this. First thing you're going to need, of course, is a mailing list. You need a mailing list in CSV format, comma-separated value file format, and it's just one column email addresses. You go, you sign up for a free account with Clearbit, sign in, and you go to your batch section here on the left-hand side. You upload your mailing list, and what it will tell you right away is what percentage does not work. In this case, this one, this file here is 12.5%, just flat out doesn't work. So it's really good for telling you email decay, the part that does work and the part that it's not sure, so sure about. So this here is my mailing list. This part here is my LinkedIn connections. Yes, LinkedIn connections. So if you've got a decent number of connections on LinkedIn, this is a really good way to investigate them. So let's dig in here. I'm going to go into my mailing list first. 59% match rate on overall match addresses, 46% match rate on company. So it's a reasonably good list. This, I don't want to hit that button. That's, whew, that's expensive. But where's my mailing list from? Yeah, these are people, 10,000 in the United States, 788 in Canada, et cetera, et cetera. And it goes on. You can't get much more granular than this in the free edition for obvious reasons. What are the categories of the list? My list is very heavy B2B, very heavy SaaS, consulting, some B2C, and then technology. So again, for companies, this is good to know. For technologies used, Google Analytics, Google Tag Manager, WordPress, Office 365, Apache. And these are from the company domain name. So if you've got companies with a domain name like, you know, trustinsights.ai, and it knows from other services like BuiltWith what technologies are on that website, this gives you an idea of the technology stack. I find this information useful as a proxy for understanding my list's general level of sophistication. 86% of the list uses Google Analytics. Guess what content I should be creating, right? It's not Adobe Analytics. It's going to be Google Analytics because that's what's going to serve my audience best. We see here the industries. Who is my list? Internet, software and services, professional services, other, media, education, telecom, and so on and so forth. So we get a nice breakdown of who is in my mailing list. This is, again, super important stuff to know. If I am marketing content for a certain type of industry, and that industry is not even on here, like, my mailing list does not reflect who I think I'm marketing to. Then the different roles on the list, marketing and sales, okay, that's a good to know, and that 79% other. Level, executive, manager, director. Executive, super important. If you are an influencer, this is what you want to show off to say, yeah, almost 16% of my list are top tier executives. Now, this could be, you know, I'm listed as the chief innovator of Trust Insights. We're a three-person company. So we have, I'm an executive. I'm not someone who has a multi-million dollar marketing budget, but still an executive. So take this with a grain of salt, but still for using for influence, for sales, for marketing, knowing that a good chunk of your list falls into these categories here. These are sort of the decision-making roles, right? Executive level, director level, manager level. So 16, 23, 36. So 36% of my list, so one third of my list is in some form of decision making role. That's a valuable list. I would love to know as a salesperson. I'd like to know as a marketer and as an influencer. I can go and say people, yeah, 36% of my list is in a decision making capacity. And then company size. 1 to 10 employees, 8%, 6 to 1,150, 51 to 250, 251 to 1,000, 1,000 to 5,000, 5, 10, and then 1% of my list is companies with 50 to 100,000 employees. That's a big number of those are huge companies. So knowing that there are some of those big companies on my list is useful. And then, you know, personal corporate email. The one thing this will not determine, however, is someone who is in a corporate role who puts their personal email in. So you may get people signing up, say, for your newsletter, and they may put in their personal Gmail address. Cool. I would take an email over, not an email, but it doesn't help with the market intelligence. But there's still enough here to be able to dig in. So that's what this software does. Now, again, that's where they make their money. So only push that button if you really mean it, because it's a really expensive mistake if you push it incorrectly. So that's my mailing list. Now let's go into my LinkedIn connections, right? So this is the people whose email addresses I've exported from LinkedIn. Remember, you may not email your LinkedIn connections in batch. Not allowed. You absolutely can show advertising to them through retargeting. And it's good to know who they are. So again, do we see a similar breakout here? 7,000 in the United States, B2B, SaaS, technology is third on this list, consulting, and then B2C. So more technology people in my LinkedIn network than there are on my newsletter list. Interesting little factoid. Still, B2B and SaaS is where the goods are. Google Analytics, 92% here. WordPress is a bigger share here than Tag Manager, Apache, Google Apps, and so on and so forth. But still, the bread and butter of what my LinkedIn audience cares about, still the Google Analytics. Internet software and services, professional services, other, media, education. It's a very similar breakout. So I know the industries that I'm serving. Roles, marketing, sales, other, executive, manager, director. Interesting, executive is a bigger percentage, 18% here. So this is 37%. So 37% decision makers within my LinkedIn audience. So it's a slightly more valuable audience from a decision-making perspective. And then, of course, all of our fun with company sizes. Surprisingly, well, not, I guess not that surprisingly, LinkedIn, more people, it's a social network to put in their personal email versus a mailing list. So what do you do with this information? Again, if you're a marketer, you definitely want to know what kinds of companies and things like that, particularly if you have a large database. If you've got, you know, 100 people on your mailing list, you can manually look at those addresses and go, okay, I have a sense of who's on this list. When you have a 1,000 or 10,000 or 100,000 email addresses in your database, you're going to need some help. And this is a great way of doing it. Same for sales folks. If you need to know who is in your pipeline in aggregate, and you've got a lot of, say, prospects and suspects at the top end of the funnel in your CRM, this is a great service to get a little bit of intelligence to figure out, yep, we're getting the right candidates, qualified leads in, or we're not getting the right qualified leads in, and that's why sales seems to be harder than it should be. And of course, if you're on the influencer side, this is how you prove to people who are asking that this is, you know, you have the audience. So for example, I'm an IBM champion. I work with IBM. My company's an IBM registered business partner and part of their social influencer program. The fact that 84% of my list is interested in B2B and SaaS and technology makes it a pretty good fit. On the other hand, I probably should not go pitching myself as an influencer for like shoes. It's clearly not what people are interested in. So try this software out on your list. Make sure, obviously, you read the privacy policy that's built in. I'm comfortable with it, but your company may have different regulations, especially if you are working across markets. If you are working within the EEA or more commonly the EU, you absolutely positively want to read their GDPR disclosures and all that stuff to make sure that they meet your compliance needs. But give this a try. Take some screenshots of the stuff once you run it through and see if it jives with what you see in your CRM and your marketing automation software. You might be surprised. As always, please subscribe to the YouTube channel and to the newsletter. I'll talk to you soon. Take care.
Want help solving your company's data analytics and digital marketing problems? Visit trustinsights.ai today and let us know how we can help you.